Okay, good evening. So we'll be starting with a new topic now, that is bad loans. So over here we'll be discussing about non-performing asset. We'll try to understand what is stressed asset, what is NPA, then other concepts like loan waivers, writing off loans, etc. So these concepts are important because today NPA has become a major issue in banking sector. Okay, so most of our banks, including public sector banks mainly, okay, they have large number of loans that are not being repaid. Okay, so that is all turning into a non-performing asset. That means loans are assets for the banks. And if they are not performing, means that means either the interest which is due is not being paid or the principal amount which is due is not being paid. So that means ultimately it becomes a loss for the government. For the banks. Okay, ultimately it becomes a loss for the bank if these assets are not recovered. Right. So in this context, we will discuss what is bad loans or what is non-performing assets. Okay. So the the scope of this class is that we'll be discussing what is NPA, how do we define what is NPA, what is the cause of NPA, its impact on the banks, impact on the economy, and then lastly, what measures are being taken by the RBI, by the government to address NPAs. Is that understood? So these are the four things that you have to know with NPA. Okay, now, so the context in what we are discussing, like if we take last year's data, okay, so the total stressed asset in public sector bank amounted to 10 lakh crores of loans that the public sector banks had given has become NPA. Okay, that means it is, under stress. 10 lakh crore is under stress. Is that okay? So in this context, even today, the stress is being felt by the banks, and because bank is an important player in our economy, the economy is also under stress. Okay, so this is the context under which we will try to discuss this particular topic. Is that okay? So some data just like this, a 10 lakh crore worth of loans have become NPA. That means there is a danger that it may never be repaid, recovered. Okay, so it will become a loss for this banks. Okay, now try to understand this by a question. So consider the following: non-performing asset, restructured loan, return off asset. Which do you think is a stressed asset?
What do you think?
All the three? Sure. Okay, anyways, now we'll discuss what each of them are. What is NPA, what is restructured loan, and what is return off asset. Now, what is an asset for the bank? It is the loans that the banks have given is an asset. So asset, in addition to loans, it is also investment. So if banks have made some other capital investment, that's also an asset, plus loans. So loans plus asset together is known as the asset of the bank. All of you agree with this? Now, so the quality of the asset depends on various factors. That means if the interest is being paid, or if the principal amount is being recovered, then it is a good quality asset. If they are not making profit, or if it is never going to be recovered, then it is a bad quality asset. Further, what is NPA? NPA is an loan whose interest or principal amount is not being repaid. That means the due date is there, but they have not yet repaid. That is what is known as non-performing asset. But not all, the stressed asset includes NPA, but other things also. Now, what does stressed asset includes? It includes NPA, it includes restructured loan, and also it includes return off assets. So what is NPA? NPA is when the interest or the principal amount is not being repaid, that is NPA. Then what is restructured loan? Anybody? What is restructured loan? Yes. So when they change the conditions of the loan, that is known as restructured loan. That means either the interest to be paid will be changed. That means if it was 10% interest, they'll say, okay, fine, at least you pay 7%. Or if the loan period was 10 years, they will extend the period. Or they will give more loan so that they will be able to use that new money to start a new venture and make profit and repay back the old loans also. Anything. So the banks and the person who has taken loan or the company which has taken loan will negotiate with each other and will restructure the loan into a new loan, new form, Okay, conditions will be different so as to reduce the burden on those who have taken loan. Now if I have taken loan and it is difficult for me to pay, I'm honest but I want to pay, but I have difficult times, I'm not able to pay, that time the bank will say, okay fine, I'll give you a better condition, I'll increase the time, I'll reduce the interest, you pay it, correct? No, so that is restructured loan. And what is return of assets? We'll discuss. Return of asset is basically when the banks have to show in their accounts, okay, the NPA being replaced by its profits is known as return of asset. I'll discuss one by one. So NPA, you understood. So what is restructured loan? Either you extend the repayment period, matlab if it is 10 years, extend it to say 15 years, reducing the interest rate. So instead of paying 10%, the banks will say you pay 6%. Okay, then converting a part of the loan into equity so as to reduce the burden on the company. Now the companies don't have to pay so much loan because the part of the loan is converted into equity, ownership or shares. Okay, or providing additional finance. All these loans, okay, which has been converted into new loan is called as restructured loan. That means bad loans is modified into new loans is known as restructured loan. Yes, so that is restructured loan. Next, so if you have read newspaper recently, okay, so public sector banks have written off 2.42 lakh crore loans in the past 3 years. That means public sector banks have written away, okay, 2.42 lakhs. So what do you mean by this write off? What do you mean if a loan is said to be written off? Okay, does it mean that they don't have to pay the loan back? So what is loan write off or debt write off? Does it mean that they don't have to pay these loans back? So the it is maaf, you don't have to pay it back. No? Might not be. Okay. So see, public sector banks have written away these loans. That means they don't expect them. Okay, it is gone now. It will be kept on hold. Negotiation. Okay. Anyway, so what is this word write off? The word write off means, see, basically you are just cleaning the balance sheet of the banks. That's all. So the banks, let's say their income minus expenditure equals profit. Yes. So for this profit, let's say they have to pay income tax. Now, in addition to this, they also have non-performing assets. They also have non-performing assets. Okay, so what happens is the banks under the Income Tax Act, this is just a accounting procedure. Write-off is just an accounting procedure. So what the banks are allowed to do under the IT Act is that they have to compensate the NPA through their profits in the balance sheets. That means if they have made, let's say, 100 crore profit and they have an NPA of 30 crore. So the ultimate profit will now be 70 crore because this 30 crore has to be compensated by profit. And now they will be paying income tax for 70 crore. And later, as you said, when it is recovered, let's say after 2 years, this 30 crore will be added to their profit after 3 years. Is that understood? So this is just an accounting procedure under the Income Tax Act. So bank don't count the money that the borrowers owe. That is, NPA is not counted. That's all, for accounting purpose. This doesn't mean that the borrowers are pardoned. That means they don't have, it's not like they don't have to pay. They have to pay. Recovery procedures is still going on. The banks are still sending gundas to their house to recover the loan. That is going on. Okay, but it is not counted for their calculation of profits. Okay. So why? This is merely to clean up their balance sheets under the Income Tax Act. This is a normal procedure under the Income Tax Act where the banks show the NPAs as, compensate the NPAs through the profits. Okay. So in India, loan write-off is technically done under the Income Tax Act 1961. The bank should use part of its profit. Banks use part of its profit to replace the bad loans. Is that understood? So this is what is known as write-off. It doesn't mean they are pardoned. They have to pay these loans. So politically, it makes a statement. If you remember when that article came in the newspaper, opposition party said, oh, all the corporate loans are being written off. Okay, the public write-off means, oh, it is not to be paid. Write-off doesn't mean it is not to be paid. Write-off is only for accounting purpose.
So it's a very theoretical aspect.
Yeah, no, accounting. You might have heard every time a new election and new government comes, what will they do? They announce loan waiver. Okay, so loan waiver, whatever, which every government, I just got this article, so I put it. So they announce loan waiver. Okay, so what do you mean by loan waiver or debt waiver? Is it same as restructured? No. Then here they don't have to pay the loan. Those who have borrowed don't have to pay the loan. Then who pays? Are you sure? Or the public sector banks have to incur the loss? Government will pay. So government pays the loan. Government means whose money it is? Again, our money only. Okay, so public money is used ultimately to pay these loans on behalf of the banks, mainly public sector banks or cooperative banks. So the loan waiver is that. So debt waiver or loan waiver is when government declares it. Okay, the basically government has to pay the loan on behalf of the borrowers. The borrowers don't have to pay. Okay, so usually for farmers, student loan waivers, etc. Okay, so this is it will be equivalent to write-off, but here the banks will not compensate it. Who will compensate it? The government will compensate. But here the government pays the loan on behalf of the debtor. There is no cause of default. This, it does not become default. It is not under stress. So that is why we don't put it under stressed asset. I hope you understood. See, stressed asset includes your loan NPAs, okay, your restructured loans and written off. It does not include loan waiver. Loan waiver is not stressed asset. Why it is not stressed? Because assured, it is assured that it is going to be repaid. I hope you understood, so that confusion should not be there. So debt waiver or loan waiver is not stressed asset. Maybe it is a stress for the government, but it is not a stress for the banks, because the government is now paying the loans. So it does not turn into becoming a stressed asset. Understood, all of you? Okay. So if we see the question now, yes, so NPA, restructured loan, written off. Which of the following is stressed asset? Yes, all the three are stressed asset. So having understood what is stressed asset, now we'll go to the actual topic, that is non-performing asset.